We're going to take a look at a great strumming song, Badge, written by Eric Clapton and George Harrison. Now, it kind of came about in an interesting way because Cream had been working on, they were working on their last album. Everybody had to come up with some songs. And Eric was having trouble coming up with songs, and so he kind of was hanging out with his buddy George, and George sort of helped him get this rolling. And and Ringo was around at the time. He actually contributed a little bit too, kind of a drunken line about swans in the park and things like that. So the lyrics are not really supposed to make any sense. It was designed to be a kind of whimsical thing. But interestingly, they didn't really have a title for it. George was working furiously on writing out words and things like that, and Eric was across the table from him there, I think. And they put... George had written out, there's a part in there, there are basically two parts. There's a verse, A minors to D's and stuff like that, and then there's a bridge, an instrumental bridge. Well, it's not instrumental, it starts off instrumental, and then there's the vocal parts over that. So George had written down bridge on the page he was talking about that section. And Eric, looking at it upside down, said, hey, what's this song called Badge or something? And, well, it eventually stuck, that it just became the name of the song. The word has nothing to do, of course, with the song, although later on in live versions, Eric would make up a line about his badge and just to try to tie it all in. So anyway, the song originally appeared on the last Cream album, Goodbye Cream, the song wasn't even released until they had already broken up. They were already heading separate ways. Matter of fact, on the inside of the Goodbye Cream album, all the songs are listed on tombstones, kind of a mark of things to come. The rhythm guitar part to Badge can be played very simply, just using a straight rock strum. Down, down, up, down, up, down, up. Quarter and 6/8. All it needs is a really steady rhythm going in there. You could also kill the strings on the second beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. By laying down your fourth finger, I've talked about this in some of my other strumming things, so be sure to check the lessons that I have on strumming patterns and strumming techniques and all that kind of stuff. But down, dead, up, down, up, and you could kill them again on fourth beat. So that strum would be this. So that sounds more like a snare drum. And you could do that on pretty much every chord in here. Go to the D and the E minor. Or you could leave without it. So again, it was two measures of a measure of A minor, a measure of D, and two measures of E minor. Here it would be without the snare beats. Here it would be with it, second line. There is a section in Badge called the bridge. It's when they get into this nice picking, and it's very reminiscent of some of the other type picking that George Harrison had been doing in Here Comes the Sun and stuff like that. So let's take a look at that. Hopefully get the tablature out that you have there in front of you that just has some strumming parts of the chords. And what this really does just revolves around a D chord, except you never need your middle finger on the D. So you're going to start this with, at least not the very first time, but every other time you're going to come around, you're going to be starting with your first finger and third finger where they would normally be for D. And that's going to be your beginning to this picking that you're going to alternate down and up strokes on every note. Some of the accents, much like in I'd Love to Change the World, some of the accents are not where you expect them. There's going to be some ups on bass notes and things like that. But hit the first note open, go with your fourth finger for the F sharp, and then down on the A that is part of the D chord. Then your third finger reaches down to start playing a C chord. So those first four notes are played open, fourth finger, and first finger, and then your third finger as if you're going to a C chord. Now you just have a normal arpeggio starting with an up though on that C. So it's up on the C, down on the next three strings. Let's try a slow down metronome sing along with this. Now, I have to do this an octave lower than where Eric sang it, and so it's not going to sound as good. We're going to slow it down. Because just to make it a little bit easier to play, and have no idea if this is going to work or not. I've got the metronome set at 90. Let's see what happens. 3, intro, A minor to D. Let's do it again. And see if I can find these notes.
Thinking about the times you drove.